Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Knowledge Unlimited, and in this video I am going to explain about peak time. As I already told you, these are called as time domain specifications, and in that this is the second important specification that is called as peak time. Now here you can look at the definition that the peak time is defined as the time taken by the response to reach the peak value or maximum value, which means, as I already shown you, the response will be somewhat like this, and our input is unit step. So if you see here, it is crossing the maximum value and it is reaching this is one, right? Unit step input is the input given by us in the previous video. So this is the maximum value that is reaching by this response, and if you consider, this is called as first overshoot and this is called as first undershoot, this is called as second overshoot and this is called as second undershoot, and this is the first overshoot will be the maximum value. So the time taken for the response to reach this value is called as peak time. Now as I already told you, maximum value, we have one statement in differential equations, that is, any function f of x is maximum, then we can say that the value at which it is maximum is called as, if you do the differentiation of that with respect to the independent variable and if you equate that to zero, then you will get the value at which this maximum occurs. So now I am going to follow that thing only. So the time is at t equal to t peak, that is the time where the maximum value is occurring. So at that time, derivative of the response d c of t by dt, because c of t is the response, input is the unit step input, and the it is given to the second order system function, and we are getting c of t as the response. If we equate that to zero, then we will get the maximum value, which is at tp. So derivative of c of tp by dt equal to zero is the precise definition, you can say. Now we all know that c of t equal to 1 minus e power minus zeta omega n t by root over 1 minus zeta square into sine of omega dt plus theta, where I already told you that omega d equal to omega n root over 1 minus zeta square. For time being I am writing simply as omega d, but we are going to use this in the further video. So now I already derived this expression in my previous video. If you don't know, you can look at that video, it is very simple and you can learn that. So now we are going ahead from this point. Now our aim is differentiating this with respect to t. Now you can see that if you differentiate constant, it is equal to zero, so I am directly writing at zero. And minus of, I am taking 1 minus 1 by root over 1 minus zeta square as common, because the independent variable t is not involved in that. Now our aim is to differentiate d by dt of e power minus zeta omega n t into sine of omega dt plus theta. Now if you look at that carefully, here you can differentiate them using the formula of d by dt of uv. So now as two products are there, now I am differentiating that with respect to this formula. Now going ahead, let me first differentiate e power term, that is minus 1 by root over 1 minus zeta square into differentiating, let me write sine of omega dt plus theta into derivative of e power minus zeta omega n t is, it will remain as itself, and you are going to get new term, that is minus zeta omega n. Now I can write plus, now I am leaving this zeta omega n t aside, and derivative of sine is cos of omega d t plus theta into omega d, since you have to differentiate this inner argument also. Now from this I can write it as minus 1 by root over 1 minus zeta square into minus is there, it will come ahead, e power minus zeta omega n t into zeta omega n into sine of omega dt plus theta plus I am expanding this omega d, that is e power minus zeta omega n t into omega d is omega n root over 1 minus zeta square into cos of omega dt plus theta. I hope you are clear till now. Now it's very easy. You can see that e power zeta omega n is common in both these. So now I can take that as common. So minus 1 by root over 1 minus zeta square into, I am taking this e power minus zeta omega n t into zeta as common. Now I am left over with root over 1 minus zeta square into cos of omega dt plus theta. This term is completed, and here I am left over with minus omega n is taken, omega n should be taken as common here. Sorry, my mistake, omega n. So omega n is common, e power minus zeta omega n is common. Now I am left over with root over 1 minus zeta square into cos omega dt plus theta, and here it is zeta into sine of omega dt plus theta. Now if you look at this carefully, let me take zeta equal to cos theta. Let zeta equal to cos theta. Now from the identity that sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1, which we all learn in trigonometry, basic equation you can say. Now I can write root over 1 minus zeta square as sin theta. Now if I replace that in this above equation, it will be minus 1 by root over 1 minus zeta square into e power minus zeta omega n t into omega n. Here it is sin theta into cos omega dt plus theta minus cos theta into sin omega dt plus theta. Now if you look at this, you can write the formula as sin a cos b minus cos a sin b. Sin a cos b minus cos a sin b, which is equal to sin of a minus b. Now simply I can write this as inner argument. First let me write sin of, here a is theta, minus omega dt minus theta. Theta theta get cancelled. Sin of minus theta equal to minus sin theta. So now replacing that in this equation, it will be equal to minus 1 by root over 1 minus zeta square into e power minus zeta omega n t into omega n. Here as minus is present, I am cancelling minus and minus, it will become plus. So sin of omega d t. Now our aim is equating this to 0 to get the maximum value. That is it. Then if it is equating to 0 means t is equal to t peak. Now we all know that this will be never equal to 0, this all constant term. So obviously the argument present inside sin will be equal to 0. When sin will be equal to 0 means, not argument, this complete value will be equal to 0 means omega dt should be integral multiples of n pi. 0 should not be present, because if omega dt equal to 0, if you take n value as 0 means, then the initial value of response will be obtained, which is not our case. So as I already told you, the first the maximum value will be obtained at first overshoot. So n value should be equal to 1. Now if you equate that, omega d equal to omega d into t peak time equal to 1 into pi. So t peak equal to pi by omega d. You can leave this as formula, important formula, which is used to calculate many problems, or you can extend that using the extension of omega d, that is omega n root over 1 minus zeta square. So this is the formula for peak time of an underdamped system, underdamped second order system. This is the peak time for underdamped second order system. So this formula is very important, and if you look at this carefully, this derivation is very simple. if you go on step by step. See here, first I have taken the normal function, that is the normal response that we have derived in the previous video, and I differentiated that with respect to t and equated it to 0 to get the maximum value, since the definition itself indicates us to get the maximum value. So, and this is completely the differentiation. If you know the differentiation, you can proceed by these steps very easily, and all you have to know is this last step where you need to substitute zeta equal to cos theta and root over 1 minus zeta square equal to sine theta. If you substitute that and if you proceed, then by equating the argument to 0, then you will get the peak time. And as time came, at this point we can extend our discussion by saying about the overshoots, finding the number of overshoots formula. So this is the response that we have obtained in the previous class. It will be somewhat like this, and my input will be unit step input like this. This is my input and this is my output. For time being, consider this. So this is called as first overshoot, and this is called as second overshoot, third overshoot, and the bottom ones, this peak is called as overshoot and this called as undershoot. So now, to know how many number of overshoots, you can say this time is called as peak time, and we obtain peak time as pi by omega d, which means first overshoot at pi by omega d. Now if you consider this second overshoot similarly, you will get at, this will be obtained at 2 pi by omega d. So the second overshoot will be at 3 pi by omega d, which means to get the number of overshoots, you can simply take as odd multiples of numbers. That is, to get nth overshoot, it will be simply 2n minus 1 into pi by omega d. To get the first overshoot, substitute n equal to 1, that is 2 minus 1, that is 1 into pi by omega d. To get the second overshoot, 2 to the 4 minus 1 into pi, that is 3 pi by d. So this is the formula for nth overshoot, very important. And to get the nth undershoot, similarly you can do analysis on your own. I am writing the formula simply even multiples, that is 2n pi by omega d, where if n equal to 1, you will get first undershoot, that is 2 pi by omega d, and n equal to 2, you will get second undershoot, that is 4 pi by omega d. So these are the important three formulas that you can expect from the concept of overshoots, and hope you guys loved this video and learned something new. That's all for this video, and see you in the next one.